Give me BCRA building science.
Hello, Durston. I'll be right there.
Didn't think anything of it at first, and then it walked a little further, and then there it was.
Any idea where that water could have come from?
No idea. It just took over. It just consumed everything. I just don't know how it came to be.
Mm-hmm. Let me guess. The janitor found it.
What took you so long?
Have you looked at the roof yet?
No, sir.
I was thinking it was going to be the second floor bathroom.
Nope. No. SDM.
Solar driven moisture?
I don't have all the evidence yet, but we'll get it. It's very typical of historical buildouts of this type. Let's mask it off. Okay, let's see what we got here. Time to go infrared.
Sealed the area for containment.
Looks really good. All right, let's get ready to make the invasive incision. We'll mark out the stud points. All right, go ahead and make a mark right there. And we'll come back, let me see here, about 16 inches right about here. And we're using the infrared to show us the exact stud cavity here so we can make a clean incision. Without hitting any electrical or plumbing or the studs themselves. And what we expect to see beyond the gypsum wallboard is the arch nemesis of mold growth. Sure enough, we're condensing on our polyethylene vapor barrier just beyond, and mold growth has begun. Remove the vapor barrier, which is a 4 mil polyethylene sheet. Here we have our insulation, our stud bay insulation. Looks to be about an R30. I'll just take a chunk of this back to the lab. And if you look beyond that, what we're expecting to see is the brick wall. And indeed, there is nothing between the brick wall and the insulation, which is our major source of water.
Well, let's do a little brick 101, okay? 70 years ago, just a little fact here, a lot of transient laborers came through, so a lot of different methods of brick masonry. Most of them were a mass masonry construction. A lot of these buildings were warehouses. So they didn't intend to have a conditioned environment. You know, they didn't have air conditioned environments inside of them. So it was just a brick masonry type mass wall. Similar to this, where we have the exterior, we have the interior. The moisture would fluctuate throughout the year, but it would never get all the way through here. So they weren't concerned about having moisture go through. But then you introduce, today, a new studded cavity with insulation in it, and a vapor barrier and sheetrock. What you're doing, especially when you've got a south-facing wall like you have, where you've got the solar component driving the moisture in, is coming in and it's hitting that vapor barrier right there. And depending upon what the temperature is of this surface, it could be condensing there or somewhere in this area through here. So So now you've got yourself a built-in problem.
Thanks, Ken.
Let's see what we have here. Yes. 4 mil polyethylene class 1 vapor barrier. That's non-vapor permeable.
Well, I don't know what I'm looking for, but I know that I just wanna look some more. And I won't be satisfied till there's nothing left that I haven't tried. For some people it's an easy choice, but for me there's a devil and an angel's voice. Well, I don't know what I am looking for, but I know that I just wanna look some more.
Obviously, no one told him about ham.
Well, Lee, it looks like our construction details for the envelope are coming right along, wouldn't you say?
It's looking great. All I have to do is give him ham. That's creating a barrier for heat, for air, for moisture vapor, and moisture liquid. And they've got ham and a good barrier.
Sounds good.
Just a second here, I'm getting a call. Hello, Durston. I'll be right there. Ken, I gotta run. Another case. Don't forget, what's for dinner? I hope you're not a vegetarian.
Not at all.
Just, you know, doing my normal job.
Yes. In the elevator?
Sweeping? No, not in the elevator.
Are you cold, Dave?
No,
do you want
okay.
Some tea?
No, I'm all right.
Can some tea help you?
No, no, it's okay. Thanks.
All right.
Solar-driven moisture? Incredible.
Action.
I've sealed the area for containment.
Looks really good, Roger. Let's get it ready to cut in, make it invasive. Hole. We'll mark
cut.
The cut.
Cool.